biggest question that comes up when you ask people why they don't cycle is because they don't feel safe, or because they don't feel that their bikes are safe. So I mean, the two things, whether you look at security of personal security on the road or the security of your bike, both of those things are really issues that stop people from cycling.
We know that around 70% of people won't cycle because they perceive it to be too dangerous. So we're helping cities by giving never before seen insights on how people move around our cities using micromobility to help them understand it better, to make provision for better infrastructure, and ultimately to help people transition to make those journeys sustainably.
Transport for London is a London Transport Authority. We're not just responsible for the upkeep of the London Underground, but we also look after the bus network and the main roads in London. So that's also things like thinking about safest junction schemes and cycling infrastructure. The Vision Zero proof of concept was an innovation fund project. We wanted to understand the safety on the road network from the point of view of vulnerable road users. So that includes people riding bikes, micromobility, and also using motorcycles. This would help us understand where near misses were occurring, and therefore where risk was highest to those cycling around the city.
We look at, for example, how they're braking or swerving, and any abnormal or braking swerving behavior gives us some really good insights and clues as to where the journey is not working as efficiently or correctly as it should do.
It's really useful for TfL, as that will allow us to identify locations where we can put interventions. So that could be from fixing some of the potholes, introducing cycling infrastructure, or even changing the complete layout of the road.
One of the great things about C-Sense is we've been able to gather so many partners and so much data.
We installed a number of C-Sense devices on our scooters, and within 10 weeks, we measured over 1,800 rides and over 8 million sensor readings. These sensor readings help local authorities prioritize infrastructure investment and help us identify areas for hotspots where there might be collisions in the future.
My understanding of C-Sense is that it is monitoring the way I'm cycling. It specifically knows that I'm a woman, so it knows the kind of cycling that I'm doing. It knows when I'm braking, when I'm swerving. It allows me to report problems along my regular route. All of those things can only make a better, can make a better place for cycling. Female cyclists are the fastest growing group of people taking to bikes, and you can see that on the streets of London particularly. I think particularly since the pandemic, numbers of cyclists generally have grown, but there are definitely more women who want to ride bikes and who are riding bikes, but they're not necessarily feeling that their routes are catered for. So again, collecting this sort of data, catering for a new growing group can only be a good thing.
So by getting data on things like hard braking or swerving, we can understand how our vehicles are really being used. And that also helps dispel some rumors to cities on their fears about our vehicles. We can also help identify hotspots where people are doing things like pavement riding. Pavement riding is something that cities are always worried about when it comes to scooters, but there's no good data on it. People have perception, but it's impossible to really measure when someone's on a pavement or not on a pavement. C-Sense can actually help us gather data and dispel some of these rumors, or understand the size of the problem, like pavement riding, which you can't do right now.
So the next steps for TfL are to understand how we can use this data with other information. So this gave us really valuable insights on cyclists, but we also want to understand how other public transport users are moving around the network and what risks they may face when they're moving. So what we want to do is take this information and layer it together, and then we can identify the predominant risks around the network, who's affected, and how we might act to fix it.